So then, well, let's kick things off properly with a couple of pictures to kind of reminisce. 03 ultimately was a great World Cup, right? You know, I think back to the World Cups that I was involved in, I've only got really good memories of that one.
Yeah, it was actually the first World Cup I was on. I didn't go in 99. And it was the first time I'd been to Australia. So in 99, there was a tour to Australia, I think the year, or just prior to the World Cup, which I wasn't picked on, and then didn't make the World Cup squad. I'd been injured the year before after the tour in South Africa and never really kind of got my form back together. So I didn't get picked on the tour, the summer tour, which is kind of the pre-World Cup tour, and then didn't go. Wasn't involved then in the World Cup, which was, of course, in Ireland at the time. So it was actually my first World Cup. We've been involved in some of the qualifying, but I was very, very much looking forward to it because I hadn't had a chance to play in the last one. And rugby and the World Cup was getting a bigger and bigger tournament. And going to Australia had the feel of more of an adventure because it was so far away. You know, the last World Cup had been in Ireland. This was now the other side of the world. And it was great to be involved for the first time. The Argentina match was where all the pressure was, and I don't think I've played in a match as tense. So there was just lots of kind of subplots, and the Argentina team at the time were a really strong side, and they had, you know, you knew playing against them, they were a real team. Like we trained in Adelaide, we trained in the military base before the match. I think they'd been trained there the day before. So we're kind of aware that we're both kind of in and around the same area. There wasn't a lot of other places, I think, for both teams to train. And yeah, they were a real team. They really played for each other.
It's quite an unusual situation to find yourself in where, you know, that you could have the most heightened stress levels prior to a game. It could be a Grand Slam game, but it usually dissipates when the whistle goes. That felt like a game that you lived that stress level for the whole 80 minutes, that it never relented.
It actually got worse. It got worse because there was so much at stake. And we just knew if we lost, we had to go beat Australia to stay in the World Cup. And then there was the baggage as well. Just like the baggage that went with the team that lost in Lens. Like up to that point, people, I suppose, forget about it now because it's you know, things have moved on or Irish rugby has moved on. But, you know, that was such a disaster, not losing a game that everyone in Ireland expected to win. People hadn't got to the grips of where Argentinian rugby were, and they certainly did know by the time the next World Cup when it came around. I don't remember a huge amount about the game. I remember, obviously, Quinny scoring that try, or as he modestly puts it, the try that saved Irish rugby, as he reminds everyone. And off the back of the line out. And kind of at the time, we kind of felt, okay, we're scored here now, we're in a bit of, you know, we've a bit of momentum. But actually, the game never really went past a one-score game.
So game is done.
Yeah.
But then you still have that awkwardness of an after-match function sometimes, particularly when one team know that they're going out of the World Cup and another team gets to progress.
I don't think I've ever been in a match, and in a match there's more if you committee men in a change room afterwards.
And that's saying something.
But it was actually, there was a collective relief. You know, everyone kind of got how important that match was. I remember Don Crowley at the time was the president, and he had the song Fernando he used to always sing. So we all end up in a rendition of Fernando, which I'm sure the Argentinians probably thought we were taking the piss out of them, which we weren't. But we insisted on Don singing the song, and we all got. It was just one of those. It was a mix between relief, euphoria, and realizing that we still had to play another match. And we went back, and anyone who was there, like anyone obviously was following the Irish team, was in Adelaide. And they all went back to our team hotel. There wasn't many options, but we went to the team hotel. We were staying at Hilton, which had a huge, big open lobby and a big balcony around it. And I just remember every single Irish supporter who had been at the game was in the hotel. Mm. It was absolutely packed. People, as I said, in the balcony, you know, sitting in the lobby. The whole place was green. The atmosphere after the game was one of the best post-match atmospheres ever. And the team was just there in the middle of it. And it was a real great moment between the team and the supporters, mm-hmm. because everyone had gathered, you know, to clap us off, and then everyone had come back, and everyone knew what the game meant to win there, because it was such a tense match, and everyone knew that there was a chance now going on to Melbourne to play Australia, to play the hosts, and we were kind of on the road after that. Mm.
So did we play our best rugby against Australia the following week in a game that ultimately we should have won?
Well, the bit I played, the bit I remember, I do remember, we didn't start that well. I remember Australia scored pretty...
George Smith, a quick try,
scored, and it was really kind of soft. One of those things. It's kind of, we obviously were playing in Melbourne in the Telstra Dome.
Yeah, Telstra Dome, so, as it was at the time.
So it was the first, certainly the first stadium. I don't think I played in one since. Obviously Cardiff now has their roof closed up, but this was the first fully indoor match that it played in, and so the noise in the stadium was insane. There was definitely more Irish people in the stadium than there was Australians. Definitely more, and they certainly made more noise because of the weekend that was in. And obviously, we had the Melbourne Cup going on. We had the compromise rules was the night before in the MCG. So the place was awash with Irish sports fans and Irish people. So wherever you went, there was Irish people. So I think, you know, I remember though in that, while when we went out, it was so many Irish people in the stadium. Like, you know, there is a feeling that has always stayed me from playing matches. When you play away from home, particularly in international, when, not so much when you get a penalty against you, but when you get a score, an early score, the noise from the crowd, like, it's just, it kind of just resets you that you're playing away from home and you're the away team. And the home team are playing at home, and they're gonna be impossible to beat playing in front of their home crowd. And just they scored so fast, and the roar that went up from Australians after thinking we had far more supporters, like the noise that came out from the Australian crowd, and because it reverberated in around the stadium, it was a real shock, because obviously we had the euphoria of beating Argentina, we won our pool matches, we were full of confidence going into the match, notwithstanding we were playing a brilliant team, and then they scored straight away. We're thinking, okay, we're right back down to earth here. It really did, and they had such a good side. Like, they had so many big players who were kind of running the show. Like, Gregan was, even in that opening minutes, he was running across all the kind of signature plays that they built that I had. You know, we played against Australia, but you really seen them in full flow. You're watching it in real time, and we couldn't really do anything about it. You know, we just weren't in the game, but we got back into the game, and we did play. Certainly, I don't think we played as well in the tournament. Unfortunately, certainly in the next match, but we played some really good rugby in that match.
You and obviously. Tore your Achilles. What stage of the game?
Just before halftime. Not too far before halftime. I can't remember exactly, but it was pretty close to halftime.
So do you remember the second half? Did you watch it from the sidelines? Did you go indoors?
Yeah.